to come up with y equals, what have we come up with?
7 plus 2x.
Okay. What, is that what you had, Hunter?
What?
Is that what you had?
I didn't know what she said.
7 plus 2x.
7 plus 2x.
Oh, no.
Is that what you had?
All right, well, let's just test it out. Okay? So it starts out at 7, right? So when is it 7 inches high?
2 seconds.
Zero.
At 0 seconds? Yeah, no time has passed. It just starts off at 7 seconds. So at 0 seconds, we should see 7 inches. Right? Let's try it with this function. Y equals 7 plus 2 times 0 seconds. What's 2 times 0?
Zero.
0 plus 7?
7.
So at 0 seconds, it's at 7 inches. Is that tracking?
Yes.
Yeah. Does that work? Yeah. Let's try after 2 seconds. You just tell me intuitively, after 2 seconds, how high will the water be?
11.
14.
11.
11.
It's 11.
11.
14.
It'd
be
11.
It's
11. 9. You don't have to know math. You just have to think about it.
9.
9.
11.
2 seconds.
11.
11.
14.
11.
11.
11.
4 inches.
Okay. In 1 second, how many inches does it go up?
9, 2, 3.5.
1 second. 1 second. How many inches, listen to the question, does it go up? How many inches does it go up?
2 inches per second.
In 1 more second, how many inches does it go up? Okay, so it should be at how many inches?
11.
3.5 equals 7. Plus 2 times 2, 2 times 2 seconds. 7 plus 4?
11.
Yeah, 11. So, when we plug in 2 seconds, it's at 11 inches. So it seems to be working, right? We have an intuition about it. We can think about the situation. It starts at 7, and then, 5 seconds later, how many more inches will it be 5 seconds later?
17.
10.
Any more?
10.
10 more. 5, right? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 more inches, starts at 7. So 10 more inches than 7 is 17. And that would work if we plug in 5 here. We get 2 times 5 is 10, plus 7 that it started with, 7. Okay. Notice how we started at 7 inches. We have a rate of 2 inches per second. Okay, let's look at the graph. 1 second later, as I move over 1 second, move over 1 second from there, there's a little tick mark right there. How many inches are added on? 2 inches, right? 1 second goes by. 2 more inches added on. Let's say 2 inches above that is right there, right? 9 inches. Okay, another second. Let's say I go another second into the future. What happens then? What goes up how many more in that 1 second?
Two more.
Okay, so it's gone up a total of 4 so far. 1 more second goes by. What happens then?
2 more inches
for a total of 6 now. We can see what's happening here. It's just going to keep going up at that rate. It's going to follow that pattern. What's that?
Plus 2.
Every time a second goes by, it goes up 2 inches. All right. Okay, very similar. Traded out the numbers. Write an equation, each of you, in your notes. It gives us the height after x 7. Okay, who's got an equation that think works? Marcus?
Y equals 3x plus
3x plus 5.
That's
right. Everybody agree? 3x plus 5?
5x plus, 5 plus 3x.
Wow. Will that be the same?
That's the same.
Yeah, okay.
It is the same. Don't ridicule. Question, right? So we add 3x plus 5, or 5 plus 3x, it's the same thing. This is a number, right? These are the same two numbers being added together, just in a different order. So it starts off at 5 inches. 1 second later, what happens?
It goes up three more inches.
So probably about there, up to 8 inches, right? It goes 1 second goes by, 3 inches of height are gained. 1 second later, what happens?
Goes up another.
Very good. Another 3 inches. And that pattern's going to keep continuing. And that ratio is always the same. We could go, let 2 seconds go by. How many inches go up?
Six,
right? Over one up three is the same as over two and up six. What if we only go over, a half a second? A half a second goes by. How much water?
12.
How high does the water increase?
0.5.
12 inches? One half of 1 second. One half of 1 second. How much?
1.5.
Right? Half the amount of time, half the amount of inches. The ratio is also always 3 to 1. 3 inches to 1 second. Or three, however many to however many seconds, always comes out to be 3 to 1. So we see again this guy here, 3 to 1 is the rate. 3 inches to 1 second is the rate of change. We see the rate of change on the graph too. It's just on the graph when you move over one and up three, that's what we call. Anybody remember?
The slope.
I heard somebody say it, I don't know who it was. The slope. Marcus? Alright, Marcus. So over one and up three. One more time. I think just as a class this time, all together, what equation would tell us how high this water is after x seconds? Hunter?
So 5 inches mean 5x plus 3.5.
Very good. So we are always seeing this guy in the equation, right? This guy makes its way into the equation because that's where it starts, right? And then it only, right, this is a positive, it only gets bigger from there. We add it on. We add on 5 inches for every second that goes by. Okay? So we see this rate come right into the equation. Starts at 3.5 inches. 1 second later, what happens?
3.5 plus 5 inches.
Nice. 5 more inches on top.
I got
5 more inches. 1 second goes by. What happens in that 1 second?
5 inches.
And the pattern continues. If that glass were infinitely tall, it would just go on forever. Okay. Now I'm gonna put a little twist in it. And I want you to see what you come up with in this equation that you're gonna write. I'm gonna make the rate a little different. The rate is gonna look like 4 inches every 3 seconds. Not 4 inches a second, right? 4 inches every 3 seconds. See what kind of equation you come up with now. Notice what I said. This guy right here makes its way into the equation because that's where it starts. It needs to start there and then get, increase from that point. And this guy here, 5 for every 1 second. I can write even 5 per 1. It's kind of redundant, but I can write 5 inches per 1 second, right, times the number of seconds. I'm just going to write down that equation. It has every time for the last 3 times you've done it. So, what do you think the equation in this situation might be?
4/3 plus 6.
4/3 plus 6? Oh, I have
4/3 times 3.
Oh, 4 times 3.
Minus 6.
4 times 3 minus 6. But with this equation, let's just, like, this is just a number, right? 4 times 3 is what?
12.
Minus 6.
6.
But now it'll never change. It'll just always be 6. But the height changes, doesn't it?
Yeah.
So there's at least one thing missing from here. What are we missing?
X.
We need an X in there. We need an X.
Oh, I
need 3X.
Can you just shove 3X in there?
Yeah, no.
Okay, well, 4 times 3X would be 12X.
Minus 6.
Again.
Oh, 4, no, I don't know about that.
I get it.
Let's back it up.
When you turn it into a fraction?
Turn what into a fraction?
4/3.
4/3
is used as a fraction.
It is. It's already a fraction, right?
No, I can leave it as a fraction.
Leave it as a fraction. So it would look like what?
4/3.
4/3.
X.
X.
Plus 6. Right? Did I get that right?
Well, it sure follows the pattern we've seen, right? In the previous one, the rate that it's going comes down and multiply by X plus whatever it started as. Let's see what we got here. There it is, the starting point, plus the rate times x. Let's test it. Let's test it. Just forget about this equation for a second. Just think it with your intuition. It starts at 6 inches. Now you pick any time in the future you want. Pick any time in the future you want. Can you tell me how high it is at that point? You can go 1 second in the future, 20 seconds in the future, whatever you want. Can you just tell me at some point in the future how high it is? Remember, forgetting about this equation, just use your intuition.
Six.
Six what?
Inches.
Inches.
When?
Into the future.
Six is inches into the future.
No, six.
Six seconds.
Okay, you want to go six seconds into the future. I did say into the future, so zero is not a choice. Into the future. Go to the future 6 seconds.
That was so good sense. You said to look at the fraction.
Because what?
You said to pretend like the fraction isn't there.
No, not the fraction's not there. Just forget about the equation, but all this stuff is still true.
3 seconds.
You want to go 3 seconds in the future?
Yeah.
Instead of six?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go 3 seconds into the future. Let's call 1 second, 2 seconds, 3 seconds. 3 seconds in the future, what's the height then?
Three.
The height is three?
Sorry, six.
12, 3, 4, 3, plus 3, plus 18.
10. Here's something different.
It's 4 plus 6. 18.
4 plus 6.
18.
Yeah. 18. No, it's
10.
18. Yeah.
In 3 seconds, how many inches will it go up?
6.
4 over yeah. 3.
It says right here.
4 inches.
18.
Up.
In 3 seconds, it'll go up 4 inches.
No. Yeah.
3 seconds have gone by. How many inches should it go up?
Four.
Starts at six. Go over 3 seconds. How many inches should it go up?
Four.
It should go up four. And four might be like right about there. It'll be where? 10 overall, right? 3 seconds go by. 4 inches added on. Starts at six. 0 seconds and 6 inches. 3 seconds go by. 4 inches are added on to the height. Oh, what about a 6 seconds? Right, that's 3 seconds later. 3 seconds later, how many more inches are added on?
Four.
Four more inches. Every 3 seconds, four more inches.
And 18.
Come back.
Starting to see a pattern, right? I hope we see the pattern there. Every 3 seconds that go by, 4 inches are added on. Okay, so that's just our intuition. We have not consulted the equation yet. But let's look at this point. This point says that at 3 seconds, it should be how high?
10 inches.
Let's consult the equation here. 4/3 times 3 seconds plus 6. I should have written why you're
12 over 3.
4 plus
12 over 3.
And then that equals 4.
That's
plus
4.
Six.
4 plus 6. 10. It certainly seems to have worked. We plugged in 3 seconds, we got 10 inches. Let's just try one more. Try 6 inches. Let's switch colors. Y equals 4/3 times 6 over 1 plus 6. Well, 4 times 6 is 24, right? It's over 3. 24 over 3 is
8 plus 6 is 14.
Well, if we were at 10 inches here, we would have 4 more. That is what it should be, 14, right? Seem to be working?
Yeah.
Good, right? Here, let's think about this real quick. What if I take this equation and I plug in 1? First of all, what does 1 represent? 1 what?
1 over 1.
1 units of it. Second. 1 second goes by. Okay. Well, what's 1 times 4/3?
4/3.
4/3. So after 1 second, how many inches are added on? 4/3 of an inch are added on. Here's 1 second, right? Go up 4/3 of an inch, so that would be 1 1/3 inches. So we should be at 1 second, comma 7 1/3 inches. So you can think of it as 4 inches every 3 seconds. You can think about 4/3 of an inch every 1 second. You could also think of it as 8 inches every 6 seconds. The ratio is always the same. However many inches I go over, I'm going to go up 4/3 times that many inches. And when we move over in sections of 3 inches, that makes it really easy. 4/3 of 3 is 4. So it makes it easy to move over 4. So I move over 3 and up 4. Over 3 seconds and up 4 inches. All right, so quite a bit of talk about that last one. Let's give this one a try individually in your notes. All right, I'll bet we've got a lot of people with an equation that works this time. Sid, did you have one? Now, the equation that I want, though, is an equation that can change, that I can plug any number of seconds into. So yours is specifically 5 seconds, but we just want to leave it open. How do we leave it open?
X.
Leave it open with X. Now, we can plug 5 in for X. Great. But we'll leave it open for any number of seconds. Okay, so it starts off at 4.25 inches, and every...
6 seconds.
5 seconds.
I know you did that. 5 seconds. Let's call this a tick mark. 2 seconds, 4, 6. So 5's right there. So every 5 seconds, what happens?
It goes up 6 inches.
It goes up 6 inches, right? There's our rate of change. But I don't know if I've said this in this class. I've probably said this multiple times. Number one thing that incoming math students, particularly calculus students, coming into college don't understand is the relationship between a graph and the rate of change. Okay. So here's the rate of change. The rate of change is 6 inches every 5 seconds. We will look at the graph, that translates to the slope. Every 5 seconds they go by, we add on 6 inches. That looks like about 6 inches, judging by this 4.25 here. And that will just keep happening. 5 more seconds go by, and what happens?
Up
6 more inches get added on, right? Let's try it. You can plug 5 seconds. So if 6 inches were added on top of this 4.25 inches, then how high would this be?
That would be 6
on top of 4.25. I heard somebody start to say, and I went ahead and wrote it, 10.25 inches, right? 6.25. Let's try it out. Let's test this equation and see if it's working. Y equals 6/5 times 5, right? 5 seconds later. You can choose any number, but 5 is convenient. Plus 4.25. 6 plus 4. Right, 5 divides the 5, we're left with 6 plus 4.25, 10.25. Nice, okay, working perfectly. So we see the rate times x being the number of seconds, plus 4.25, because that's where it starts. It starts at 4.25. When 0 seconds have gone by, it's already at 4.25. 4.25 inches. I don't know if it's 2 seconds or a second ago. 4.25 inches. All right, one more like that. Okay, so this equation should be y equals...
What?
Hunter?
3 over 8x plus 4.
Y
equals...
Oh, that should be
a 9.
Yeah, that was supposed to be a 9. It does look a little 4-ish. But we're all on the same page there. So 3/8 x plus 9. So it starts at 9 inches because... When is it at 9 inches? When?
3/8.
8
seconds.
0 seconds. At 0 seconds, it's at 9 inches. Just a reminder. And then, when? 8 seconds later, right? Let's call that 4, and that 8 seconds. 8 seconds later, what happens at 8 seconds later?
Goes up 3 inches.
Goes up 3 inches. We're talking about the slope now, but in a way that's meaningful. Okay. So if it goes up 3 inches, how many inches is it?
12 inches.
So we move over 8 seconds and up 3 inches, over 8 and up 3. Or 8, 3. Okay. Another 8 seconds go by, and what happens?
Three inches.
Goes up another 3.
Oh.
Another 3.
15.
Okay. We're at 15 now. All right, very good. What if only 4 seconds go by? How many inches does it go up? 4 seconds go by. Goes up
4.5.
What's that?
4.5.
4.5?
1.5.
Because if it goes over the full 8 seconds, it'll go the full 3 inches. But if it only goes over 4 inches, well, that's half the time. So it should go up half the inches. Over 4 and up 1.5. Over 2. But they are all on the same line. Climbs just the same. Very good. So we see that translation from the equation to the graph. Now we don't even really need to plug anything in for x, right? Because we can kind of see how the function works. It works like this. It starts here, and we can think of it as seconds and inches, or really anything, but every 8 seconds it goes up 3 inches, right? Or every 8 x's we get 3 y's, whatever x and y represent, right? That tells us what the rate is. So here's the rate of change is 3/8, 3 inches per 8 seconds. Here the line, the rate translates to a thing called the what again?
Slope.
The slope. The slope is 3/8. We see the numerator of the slope is delta y, the denominator is delta x. Do you remember what delta means?
Delta.
Delta is a Greek letter. It looks like a little triangle.
Is it 5?
No.
5.
No,
like
no,
5.
No.
That was pretty algebraic. They were talking about it.
All right. Delta, it just is a Greek letter that we use to represent a change.
Oh, yeah.
Change. Okay, you'll see like in science, you'll see delta t. That's the delta, well, sometimes it means delta t for time or delta t for temperature. It depends on if it's a lowercase or uppercase t. Okay. Now really it's a d, right? Delta is d. We like to use the letters this way a lot. Delta starts with a d, okay? And really, it starts with a d because the word that it really represents starts with a d as well. A difference, right? You got the sum, you got the difference. The sum is when you add, difference is when you subtract. Right, if I take this y value and this y value, I get a difference of 3. What's the difference? 3. What's the difference in time? 8. Right? Difference in time is 8, difference in inches is 3. 8/3. We'll cover that a little more, but for now, what I want you to do is not that. I want you to do this. Take this equation. First, let's talk about how it could, like, we could make it fit pretty much any situation, but we're gonna make it fit this container filling with water situation because it's what we've grown to understand. So, in this container with water, how many inches does it start with?
Two,
right? It's 2 inches off the table. Then every
7 seconds.
7 seconds, what happens?
It goes up 5.
Very good. So I just want you to translate that right onto a graph. Okay. You know where it starts. You know that so many seconds later, so many inches are added. And you can find another point, 2 points to draw a line. You got yourself a line. Right. So draw me a quick graph for this guy here. Okay, so it starts where?
2 inches,
so put 2 there. And a little point like that. And then how many seconds later do we want to go?
7.
We could go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6 seconds, but all of those would be like fractional amounts of inches. So we go all the way over to 7 inches, or 7 seconds, excuse me. We'll see a whole number of inches be added on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 seconds later. What happens 7 seconds later?
Goes up 5.
5 inches, putting us at how many inches?
7.
Exactly. Move over 7 seconds, move up 5 inches, right? I can do all that. I can find those 2 points without ever plugging in an x. Don't forget that's what these points represent. I've plugged in an x and got out a y. But I can find those 2 points by using my understanding of the rate, right? The slope, the beginning point, the y-intercept. Start at the y-intercept, move over 7 seconds, move up 5 seconds from there. Draw a really crooked line, erase it. Get a straight line tool. Redo it.
Make it perfect.
Good. Not.
Okay. Shyamalan style twist.
That was crazy.
Let's make this even bigger. Let's make this more.
Oh,
like
it goes
12.
Down.
No. 12. Okay,
it goes
12.
Down.
Not, so I changed it to a 12. Nobody leave the old number 12. Okay, plus 12. Well, Colby kind of spoiled it. That's okay because we got to make sense of it somehow. That negative there. It sure wouldn't make sense that it would do exactly the same thing as it's been doing. Every 70 seconds we add on a number of inches, right?
Right.
So if it's negative every time we move over a number of seconds, so like what's going on with this container then? Right?
So you go up 12.
No. What's, I mean, like the physical container, like how can we explain the negative? Dumpy stuff out somehow. Somebody's could be drinking the water, there could be a hole in the container and it's just spilling out. I don't know what it is. But definitely water is not coming in, it's leaving the container. So, go ahead, Brandon. You were going to tell me something.
Go up 12.
Go up 12, let's call it 12. 5, 6, 5, 3, and so on.
And then go left on the x axis 4.
Okay, left on the x axis 4.
And then down 4, 3.
Okay, if we go down 3, we'll be right here. But if I draw that line.
No, it's like down 3 and then negative.
Right. So what's that now?
You go down 3 and then negative.
Down 3.
Like
here?
Yeah.
No, on the y. Now remember this, like this is starting from our starting point and goes from there, right? Not a lot of people do that. They start here at the origin actually, they go back 4 and down 3. That's not. Right. We're starting from where we're starting from. We're starting at 12 inches high. Okay. But if I do draw this line, does it look any different than the ones we've already drawn?
No.
It still goes up?
Yeah.
Should it be going up? It's losing water. Should it go up?
No.
Go down.
Should it go down, right? The height's not increasing. The height's decreasing. It's decreasing. Let's back it up a second. It should start here. If we did go back in time, if you rewound a video of a container that was losing water, so you're watching a container video, a YouTube video of a container losing water, and you rewind it, what does it look like it's happening?
It's filling up.
It looks like it's filling up, like it's coming back into the hole, right? So if we go back in time, the height would increase. If we go back in time, the height would increase. But as we go forward in time, what happens? It decreases, right? So we go forward 4 seconds and it goes down 3 inches. And that all that is on the same line, right? It's all on the same line. And I kind of missed that other
point.
Good. There's your homework.
Yes, sir.